Tyler here. Today we're talking about HDR. What is HDR if you don't know? HDR stands for High Dynamic Range. It's the same image, taken at three different exposures, and then later blended together in post to create a high dynamic range image. It's to simulate more what our eyes see as humans. Now, what you're gonna need for HDR is a camera that's capable of taking the same image at three different exposures and a tripod. You need a tripod because these images have to line up completely to the same aspect. With that said, let's get out to the field. We're at our location at beautiful Mount Vernon. You can see the sun's to my right and the sky is gonna be blown out. We can see very quickly by taking three exposures and then later blending them together in post, you take the advantage of all the exposures. You'll get a nice clean sky, the shadows won't be dark, and all the whites won't be blown out. So let's get right down to it. First thing you want to do before I start taking any images, let's check our lens here. You want to turn off any image stabilization. On the Canon side, it's on the lens. That's already off, and I'm already on manual focus where I want to be for this. So now, let's just bring the camera back around, boot her up. All right. There we go, let's see where we're at here. All right, I'm kind of liking that frame. We'll work with that. Now, first thing you want to do is check your focus. My focus is looking pretty good. All right. And you also want to be in manual mode. Do not think you want to be in any type of program or mode or anything like this for your still HDR images. All right, now I'm going to go turn on bracketing, which is an exposure compensation. I'm gonna drag these guys all the way out. You know, you can put them here and there, and that's all part of preference. It depends on the shot, and it's always gonna change. So our bracketing is on. Let's go back to our shot. Let's look here at our exposures. Looking really good. Our middle exposure is right in the middle, dark all the way to the left, and light all the way to the right. And so you can move this around depending on what you wanna get or your situation. Now, I'm gonna put the camera on a 2-second timer, which is already on. That way, when you hit the button, camera will beep, and then it'll take the three exposures. So let's go ahead and do that. So that gave me time to pull my hand away, camera stopped shaking, and it got the three exposures. Let's check them out. Got our bright, got our dark, and we got our middle exposure. That looks pretty good. Now let's get these images over to a photo matrix and let's start processing them.
All right, we're back at the PC here. I've already processed some images in Photoshop from the RAWs. And first of all, let's talk about photo matrix. Now you can, all you do is go to hdrsoft.com. Let's go back to overview. And it'll tell you everything you need to know about HDR and basically what I'm teaching you today. But they do have evaluation copies which you can download, and what it will do, it'll put a watermark image until you decide to pay money for it. I will definitely recommend the full version, which is $100, and it is worth every single penny. When I was cheap, I went and I bought this one for $40. It's basically, you know, just a waste of money. You will overcome the features in this and then wish you had this right here. So go ahead and get this. Highly recommend it. Great software, great people. Let's go back to the program. All right, file, load bracket images. Let's go and browse for them. Let's get this in here so you can see it. Voila. Yeah, there they are. Open. Now I've already confirmed that my source images are aligned and I don't have any ghosting, and I've done all my noise reduction in Photoshop. But if you don't have Photoshop, this program does a very excellent job of doing all these. So you can select whatever you want, pull up the strength, let's see, this maximum shift. I'm not exactly sure what this is. Maybe that's the matching features. I don't use it that much. That's only one thing I don't know about the program, but everything else I know. reduce chromatic aberrations. That is basically due to your lens. If you have a very white shirt on someone and it's behind the sun, you'll see a little bit of pink or blue. It will do its best job to fix that. All right, now they're in here and we're in tone mapping. And you have Fusion too. I don't use Fusion too much. Fusion gives it a more natural look. I tend to go for the more dramatic look, the tone mapping. And we're gonna go over tone mapping today. If you want me to go over Fusion, just hit me up after the tutorial and I will make one based on the remarks I get. All right, and you have all these presets. I tend to start with this preset right here. So I'm gonna click on it. Let's go to the settings. All right, strength is basically how fake or realistic it will look. You know, I think my eyes look a little better than that, so I guess more realistically what your eyes would see would be right around, that's what I remember today, right around there. But I like contrast, so let's drag it all the way up. Yeah, looking good. It will tend to give a little bit of a halo going on in trees or around buildings, but you can adjust that. Color saturation. It is what it is. Black and white. Whole bunch of saturation. Come here. All the way up. A little too much. That's a little too red. Don't like it. See right there? When I said about chromatic aberrations, there it is. That's chromatic aberrations. But I'm not worrying about that right now because we don't need that much color saturation. So if we drag it down, see, it looks a little better. We can fix that later on. Not so much in this program, but Photoshop. Luminosity. All right, luminosity is darker and brighter. And you can kind of see what the strength does here a little more. Let's drag that down. See? The strength up. That's that halo effect I was telling you about right around there. So let's drag this guy on up. It looks pretty good. Detail contrast. Well, just gives it more contrast, basically. It's almost like a brightness and contrast slider all in one. Let's take it all the way up. I like that. It looks pretty good. Let's go down here to lighting adjustments. Now, these settings are pretty much going to vary from picture to picture. There's no one correct setting for all images. It's just going to be you experimenting with it and getting it how you like. Medium seems to work good here, so we're gonna go with that. You also have a slider version of this, which you can basically does the exact same thing, but the other one gives you buttons. I like the button version, I like to click. So we're gonna go with medium. Now let's go down a little more. All right, we got our smoothing highlights, and it is what it says. See our highlights in here? A little bit of noise going on. Let's smooth them out. See, just go ahead and smooth them out. It will brighten it up a little bit too. But I took this at a 100 ISO, so I'm gonna take it all the way down. And that little bit of noise is not a deal breaker, especially at 100%. It looks pretty good. So let's close that out. White point makes the whites, or I guess highlights, brighter and darker. So if you get something that's kind of blown out and you say, looks a little blown out, I don't like that, you just kind of drag this down and it fixes that for you. Black point, it'll make the blacks or the shadows darker. Let's drag it on up. Look at that, very dark, very contrasty, way too much. It looks almost as the sun is going down, not as it being over here somewhere. So we're gonna take that up. That looks good. I'm gonna take it all the way out. I don't need too much. Oh, well, maybe a little tiny bit. There we go. Gamma is almost like luminosity, but it tends to crank the contrast a little more. So if you take that all the way up, very bright. Take it all the way down, very dark. It's almost the exact same thing, but it tends to affect the saturation slightly more. All right, temperature. That's basically your white balance. All the way down, blue. All the way up, a lot more warm. It'll give it kind of a sepia look going on there. If you like that, you can use it, but I think it looks better right around here. All right, advanced options, micro smoothing. This all revolves around pretty much noise. Here to see it. Hold on, let's put this right around. Yeah, trees tend to show a lot of that going on. Alright, so you can micro smoothing, it'll just smooth out some of these highlights, get the noise out. You know, it looks a lot more smooth right there. It looks pretty good. But I took it at 100 ISO, like I said, so I'm going to drag it on down. That little bit of noise right there, I don't think it really hurts, especially at 100%. Now, saturation highlights. This is so give it more color in the highlights. Highlights, a little more color. It won't affect the darks. A little less color. So I'm going to track it up. I like these clouds looking nice and orange. Saturation in the shadows. Sometimes in the shadows, you'll have, not here, but your shadows will have all these crazy looking like noise going on. That's trying to really push and pull the colors as much as possible. So you can take this down, it'll take the saturation out of the shadows. See that green is pretty close to being gray? So if you take that down, it'll almost make your trees look gray. But we don't have any problem with that, so we're gonna jack it up a little bit. It looks pretty good. Shadow smoothing, it'll do its best to smooth out the shadows. Get rid of some of that noise. Shadow clipping, this one doesn't really look like it has too much of that. So I'll try my best to show this feature. Ah, there you go, see? It's thinking that this green is a shadow. So when you start to pop that up, it will just knock it out. It's because if you have a little bit of noise in there, you can it'll basically just turn all that noise that has color in there to a black to reduce some of that noise and graininess in your image. But when you're done, so we've gone through all the features here, and when you're done, you say, ooh, I really like that. I want to share it with my friends and family or sell it. Yeah, there's a little button right here. Process. Kabua. Now it's going to process it. And when it's done, there you go. You got your finished, rendered, smooth, and everything that you like about your HDR image done. And when you want to save it, just go File, Save As, and it will say HDR 1, 2, and 3. It knows you used all three of them, and it will say Tone Mat. And I'm going to use a TIFF file because it's pretty much very little compression, and I'm going to save it on out. Well, that's pretty much it. That's pretty much my take on HDR and what I've learned over the past couple of months working with it. I hope you guys like it. If you'd like me to share anything else, any questions or comments, please leave them and please subscribe. Until next time, talk to you later. Peace out.